And welcome to the sixth meeting for 2021 of the Justice Committee. We have no apologies today, and we're joined today by Joanne Lamont, MSP, and by Hamza Yousaf, MSP, the Cabinet Secretary for Justice. The first item on our agenda this morning is to continue and to complete our stage two consideration of the Hate Crime and Public Order Scotland Bill. And members should have with them a copy of the marshalled list and the groupings for debate. And before we start, can I just remind everyone that this is a fully virtual meeting today and that we will use the chat function on BlueJeans as a means of voting electronically. When we do vote, I'll call members to type Y in the chat function to record any votes for yes. And then I'll do the same in turn for no, typing N, and abstain, typing A. The clerks will then collate the results and I'll read them out and confirm which member of the committee has voted in which way. If I make any mistakes in that, please alert me immediately by typing R into the chat box, because once the next vote is called, we can't go back. If we lose connection with anyone at any point, we'll suspend for a short time to try and get people back. But if we can't do so after a reasonable time, then I'll consult with the deputy convener as to whether we can proceed fairly or not. That's the same as we've done in previous weeks. I hope that's all reasonably clear. If there are any questions, please ask them now, but if not, we'll move directly on to the next group, which concerns removal of provisions ancillary to sections 3 and 5. In this group, I call First Amendment 20 in the name of Liam Kerr, grouped with Amendments 21, 22, 23, 24, 26, 28, and 29. So Liam Kerr to move Amendment 20, please, and to speak to all amendments in the group. Mr. Kerr.
Thank you, Convener. Good morning, colleagues. Amendments 20 to 24, 26, 28 and 29 are grouped as being ancillary to sections 3 and the now removed 5. And indeed, they are ancillary. These amendments are a function of and entirely dependent upon Amendment 17, which I didn't press during the debate on that group of amendments last week. These amendments are entirely consequential and hinged upon the pressing and passing of Amendment 17, which, as we know, did not happen. Thus, to press and thus remove these sections would not be appropriate, and I therefore will not move or press these amendments today. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kerr. Does any other member wish to speak in this group? Nobody's indicating that they wish to speak. Cabinet Secretary, do you wish to add anything?
No, I'm happy that they are not being moved, and if they were being moved, I would have, of course, opposed them. But I'm happy to not say anything more than that.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. This has been a very short debate. Liam Kerr to wind up and to press or withdraw Amendment 20.
I have nothing further to say, Convener, and I therefore withdraw Amendment 20.
Thank you. Are members of the committee content that Amendment 20 be withdrawn? Members of the committee are content. So the next question is then that questions that section 6 is agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 55 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 34. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. So I call Amendments 56, 57 and 58, all in the name of the Cabinet Secretary and all previously debated. I invite the Cabinet Secretary to move Amendments 56 to 58 en bloc. Does any member object to those amendments being moved en bloc? No member objects. Cabinet Secretary?
Moved en bloc, Convener.
So the question is that Amendments 56 to 58 are agreed to. Are we all agreed? That we are agreed. Thank you. I call Amendment 59 in the name of Dean Lockhart, already debated with Amendment 32. Liam Kerr, to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener.
That's not moved. Thank you. I call Amendment 21 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr, to move or not move?
Not moved.
Not moved. So the question is that Section 7 be agreed. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 60 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
I move, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 60 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 22 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener.
That's not moved. So the question is that Section 8 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 61 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 61 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 8 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 34. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved.
Thank you. So the question is that Amendment 8 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 23 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener.
That's not moved. So the question is that Section 9 be agreed. Are we agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 62 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 33. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Move, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 62 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 63 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. And the question is that Amendment 63 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 24 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener.
That's not moved. I call Amendment. That was 20. That was Amendment 24, was it, Mr. Kerr?
Yes, sir.
Amendment 24, yes, not moved. Sorry. Sorry, I lost my place in the script. So the question is that Section 10 be agreed. Are we agreed with Section 10? We are agreed. I call Amendment 64 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 33. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Move, Convener.
The question is that Amendment 64 be agreed. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 67, I'll start that again. I call Amendments 66, 67, 68, 69, 70, 71, 72, 73, 74, and 75. All in the name of the Cabinet Secretary and all previously debated. And I invite the Cabinet Secretary to move Amendments 66 to 75 en bloc.
Moved, Convener, en bloc.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. Does any member object to a single question being put on Amendments 66 to 75? No member objects. The question is that Amendments 66 to 75 are agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that Schedule 1 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 76 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved.
The question is that Amendment 76 be agreed. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 25 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 34. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Moved, Convener.
The question is that Amendment 25 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are not agreed, there'll be a division. So can I invite all members of the committee in favour of Amendment 25 to type Y into the chat box now? Can I invite all members opposed to Amendment 25? To type N into the chat box now. Can I invite any member abstaining on Amendment 25 to abstain now? There was one vote in favour. There were right. Thank you. There was one. There was one vote in favour. There were eight votes against. Those voting in favour were Liam Kerr. Those voting against were Rona Mackay, Annabel Ewing, Shona Robertson, Fulton McGregor, Adam Tompkins, Rhoda Grant, Liam MacArthur, and John Finney. So the amendment is not agreed. I call amendments 77, 78, and 79, all in the name of the Cabinet Secretary and all previously debated. And I invite the Cabinet Secretary to move amendments 77 to 79 en bloc.
Moved en bloc.
Does any member object to a single question being put on amendments 77 to 79? No member objects. So the question is that amendments 77 to 79 are agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 26 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. Well, the question is that Section 11 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 80 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally?
Moves, Convener.
The question is that Amendment 80 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 27 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 34. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Moved, Convener.
It is moved. The question is that Amendment 27 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We're not agreed. There will be a division. All those in favour of Amendment 27, please type Y in the chat box now. All those members opposed to Amendment 27, please type N into the chat box now. And any member abstaining on Amendment 27, please type A into the chat box now. There was one vote in favour, there were eight votes against. The amendment is therefore disagreed. Those voting in favour were Liam Kerr. Those voting against were Rona Mackay, Annabel Ewing, Shona Robertson, Fulton McGregor, Adam Tompkins, Rhoda Grant, Liam MacArthur, and John Finney. The amendment is disagreed. I call Amendment 117 in the name of John Finney, already debated with Amendment 103. John Finney to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener, thank you.
That's not moved, thank you. I call Amendment 28 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. So the question is that Section 12 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 112 in the name of Rhoda Grant, already debated with Amendment 103. Rhoda Grant to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. I call Amendment 84 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 34. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Moved.
That's moved. The question is that Amendment 84 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We're not agreed. There'll be a division on Amendment 84. All those in favour of Amendment 84, please type Y into the chat box now. All those opposed to Amendment 84, please type N into the chat box now. And any member abstaining on Amendment 84, please type A into the chat box now. The result on Amendment 84 is that there were two votes in favour and there were seven votes against. Those voting in favour were Adam Tompkins and Liam Kerr. Those voting against were Rona Mackay, Annabel Ewing, Joan Robertson, Fulton McGregor, Rhoda Grant, Liam MacArthur and John Finney. The amendment is disagreed. I call Amendment 29 in the name of Liam Kerr, already debated with Amendment 20. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved, Convener.
That's not moved. So the question is that Section 13 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 85 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally?
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 85 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 86 in the name of Margaret Mitchell, already debated with Amendment 30. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved, convener.
That's not moved. I call Amendment 87 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 30. Cabinet Secretary to move formally?
Moved, convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 87 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. We move to the next group, which concerns the characteristic of disability. And I call Amendment 88 in the name of Dean Lockhart in a group on its own. Dean Lockhart to move and speak to Amendment 88? Or Liam going to do it on his behalf? I don't think we're joined by Dean, are we? No, Dean isn't with us. So Liam.
Thank you, Convener. Dean Lockhart has indeed lodged this amendment, but is unable to attend the committee session today, so he's asked me to speak to and move Amendment 88 in his name. The amendment is a simple one and was recommended by the Law Society of Scotland, of which I remind colleagues I am a member and practising solicitor. The amendment proposes a simple but important change to alter in the definition of disability the particularisation of a medical condition which has or may have a substantial or long-term effect, and replace that with the particularization of a medical condition which has had or may have a substantial or long-term effect. It is a small but crucial change which extends protections. And, you know, under the existing drafting, if the condition were to be substantial but not long-term, it is covered but only while the person has that condition. Under the current definition, if they cease to have such a condition, they would lose protection. By way of example, let's say at some future date, someone commits what would otherwise be a hate crime against people who had in one way or another struggled with their mental health to a level that it could constitute a disability. If the target of the hate crime had managed to overcome their mental health issues, but were nonetheless targeted because of their mental health, they would arguably not be covered by the legislation. Now, I cannot imagine that this was what was intended, especially as the stigma around mental health can endure for a long time. So in order to cover that scenario and ensure that the protection endures, an amendment to include or has had would, in my view, suffice. I can see no reason not to ensure this clarity, and therefore I move the amendment in Dean Lockhart's name.
Thank you, Liam. Can I call John Finney and any other member who wants to speak in this debate, please indicate in the chat box. John Finney, please.
Thank you, convener. Perhaps the first and only time I find myself supporting Mr. Lockhart on this matter, because what matters is the motivation of the attacker, what the attacker presumes. So I think this is a tidying up operation that's welcome, and I will be supporting this amendment. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Finney. No other member has indicated that they wish to speak in this debate. So can I call the Cabinet Secretary, please?
A brief on this amendment too, to say that I will be, well, the government will be supporting Dean Lockhart's amendment. We don't think it would necessarily make a practical legal difference in terms of its effect. You know, for clarity, the current provisions would already apply where malice and ill will was based on a person having had a disability in the past. For instance, if a person is the victim of an offence and the offender has demonstrated malice and ill will based on the specific fact that the victim has recovered from cancer, for example, the victim is still a member of a group defined by reference to a disability. All that being said, I take the point that Liam Kerr made on behalf of Dean Lockhart that may provide clarity, the amendment may provide clarity and reassurance that those who have had a disability or medical condition in the past and are targeted for that reason are included within the definition of disability within the bill. So for the purposes of clarity, I am happy to support Amendment 88 in Dean Lockhart's name.
Excellent, thank you very much. Can I invite Liam Kerr to wind up on Dean Lockhart's behalf and to press or withdraw Amendment 88, please?
Simply, convener, to say I'm grateful to Mr. Finney and the Cabinet Secretary for their comments. I don't think there's anything further to add, so I press Amendment 88.
Thank you very much. So the question is that Amendment 88 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 89 in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 31. Joanne Lamont to move or not move? I didn't hear, I'm not hearing Joanne Lamont. Can we try and get her on, please?
My apologies. My apologies, convener. Can you hear me?
Yes, yes. Go ahead, please.
Yeah. Apologies, I'm now having to join you by phone. Just to flag up that this amendment obviously related to the debate we had about whether sex should be included in the legislation or not. It's simply a definition of sex as is defined in the Equality Act, and the bill should have that definition in it. If we, at a later stage, after if the, we do end up with a working group, they should still be, I think, linked to the definition. However, I'm not going to move at this stage, but I do hope that the Cabinet Secretary for Justice will look at this, even if he continues to resist the idea of women, sex being a characteristic currently, but that there should be an established definition for the working group to use if that's what's agreed at stage three. But I'm not moving at this point.
Okay, thank you. That's very clear. So that amendment is not moved. So we move to the next group, which is characteristic of sexual orientation. And I call Amendment 90 in the name of Joanne Lamont, grouped with Amendments 91, 99B and 99C. Joanne Lamont to move Amendment 90 and to speak up to all amendments in the group. Joanne.
Okay. Thank you very much. And I'll move this amendment. I have to confess that I do feel rather anxious about even having this debate. It did seem to me last week that members were being condemned for even putting down amendments, even although they were within scope. And I was very concerned about, and I continue to be concerned about, our ability to stress test this bill and the provisions within it, and some closing down of the debate. And so before I speak, I just want to say briefly, I think it is essential that we can have an open and rigorous debate. I don't intend pressing these at this stage, but I do want an explanation from the Cabinet Secretary for the use of the term a different sex. It's clear in law that there are two sexes and that definitions matter. And if we're going to change from the language of the Equality Act, then I think there is a responsibility on the Cabinet Secretary to explain why. We know that there is actually in some places a debate about whether indeed sex, there are only two sexes, or whether sex is on a spectrum. And I don't think we should ignore that debate. If that is what's been suggested, then we need to be clear about that. I want to simply use the terms as referred to in the Equality Act. The purpose of my lodging these amendments was to ensure that we have an explanation from the Cabinet Secretary whether, in fact, the Scottish Government believes there are only two sexes, and if they're not, what are those other ones? And I do think it's essential in legislation, if we're changing from what is currently in the Equality Act, we have that explanation.
Thank you. Thank you, Joanne. Now, John Finney has indicated that he wishes to speak in the debate on this group. Can I just ask any other member who wishes to speak in this debate also to type R into the chat box? I call John Finney.
Thank you very much indeed, convener. Can I absolutely agree with Joanne Lamont about the need for unfettered discussion? In our unicameral setup that we have in the Scottish Parliament, the scrutiny comes of legislation comes primarily in the committees, and we must be able to express views that some others find uncomfortable. Now, Joanne knows that I don't agree with her on this particular issue, but it is important that people are respectful of differing views. Good grief, that's a reason d'etre, surely, is prompt discussions and to be courteous about them. So can I agree with her on that aspect, and then move on to disagree on the specifics of this for a very good reason, and that is about for consistency of approach. And The existing language used in the bill, and that is the term persons of a different sex, is consistent with other Scottish legislation over the past decade, including the equal marriage legislation, Marriage and Civil Partnership Scotland Act 2014, and Equal Civil Partnership, which was the Civil Partnership Scotland Act of 2020. And certainly I was involved in those days on the what was then called the Equalities Committee, and I don't recall this being a feature of the discussion in the very, very rigorous debate that took place at that time. So changing the language in the way that Islam suggests would be inconsistent with all other recent Scottish legislation. And then picking up on a point that I said in relation to the question that Dean Lockhart's amendment that we've just recently discussed, this is likely to mean, and I quote in this section from the Equality Network, this is also likely to mean that the statute of aggravation could not be applied where a sexual orientation hate crime was committed against a person because they were in a relationship with a non-binary person. And that is because their partner is presumed to be neither of the same sex nor of the opposite sex of them, but of a different sex. So it's important to bear in mind, and this is what I said in relation to the disability amendment we've just recently discussed, that what matters is the application of the application is the motivation of the attacker and what the attacker presumes the sexual orientation is. The actual identity of or legal sex of the victim or their partner is to some extent irrelevant. So I had Joanne Lamont pressed these, I would be opposing them. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, Mr. Finney. Can I call Liam MacArthur, please?
Thanks very much, Convener. A little like John Finney, I felt it was important simply to echo the sentiments that he's expressed. I mean, I'm very grateful to Joanne Lamont for lodging these amendments in no small part because of some of the debate that has been around this bill. I think we shy away from robust debate where there may be issues that arouse considerable emotion that are seen as highly sensitive. But if we don't have that debate, I think we're failing in our duties, not least, as John Finney pointed out, as the committee structure is there to do the heavy lifting in terms of the scrutiny. So I think John Lamont deserves considerable credit for bringing forward amendments that allow that debate to take place. As with John Finney, I don't happen to agree with John Lamont in terms of these amendments, but as I say, that's not to take away from the importance of having that debate. I think John Finney set out very well the consistency of the language in this bill in relation to previous pieces of legislation, and that provides me with a degree of reassurance that the approach taken is one that is worthy of support. But as I say, I think it would be remiss not to put on record the fact that the debate that Joanne Lamont has been able to prompt as a result of her amendments is one we need to have and we need to be seen to be having as well. Thanks, Gunnar.
Thank you, Liam. No other member has indicated that they wish to contribute to this debate. So can I call the Cabinet Secretary, please?
Thank you for the remarks made by both John Finney and Liam MacArthur. I've heard from them a very reasonable and reasoned articulation of why they would disagree with Joanne Lamont's amendments. And much like them, I heard their willingness to engage in a debate and discussion. So hopefully that calms the anxiety that Ms. Lamont said she had in lodging and bringing forward these amendments. No one is going to condemn her, certainly not from the government, and certainly not from your colleagues that I just heard from. And I associate myself with the remarks that Liam MacArthur and John Finney made about the need to have these debates, as uncomfortable as some of them may well be. And sometimes I'm afraid outside of this setting, outside of the setting of the committee, how unfortunately toxic some of these debates can be. We've all seen examples of that, but I'm pleased to say that certainly in this committee session, I'm certain that when we bring this discussion back at stage three in the chamber, if that is Joanne Lamont's intention, I'm sure we will be equally respectful in terms of our debate. That much like, again, the two speakers before me, I could not support these amendments if they are brought forward and pressed by Joanne Lamont, neither at this stage or indeed if they're brought again at stage three, simply because as legislators and lawmakers, we should be consistent in our approach to legislation. Different sex is a term that has been used, as John Finney said, in legislation, which actually Joanne Lamont herself has voted for previously. And it would be interesting in her summing up to understand what has changed for Joanne Lamont, where she has previously voted for the term different sex and now wishes to revert back to opposite sex. I think consistency is important. I think precedent legislation is important, but also I think being inclusive is important too. And organisations such as the Equality Network, such as Stonewall Scotland, support the use of the term different sex because they believe it to be, and I agree with them, to be more inclusive, particularly of non-binary persons. So for those reasons, I agree with the remarks made by those who have spoken before, that we should be respectful in debate, that nobody is going to close, well, certainly I've heard nobody wanting to close down this debate, but I would respectfully disagree with Ms. Lamont to be interested to hear why she changed her thinking from previously supporting different sex and now wanting to support opposite sex.
Thank you, Cabinet Secretary. Could I ask Joanne Lamont to wind up the debate and to formally press or withdraw Amendment 90, please, Joanne?
Okay, thank you very much. And I note the emphasis that people have made on respectful debate. I am concerned, however, that there's still not been an explanation from the Cabinet Secretary of whether, just to confirm, which is what the amendments were seeking to do, that he believes there are two sexes. Because there is a difference between saying you're a different sex from me to saying a different sex. I mean, it's not semantic. I haven't changed my position. And actually, the definition that we're dealing with, as opposed to conversation, the definition is that in the Equality Act. And I haven't heard an explanation of why that would change. Of course, it's important to be inclusive. Of course, it's important to be respectful. Of course, it's important to understand how people feel about themselves and about the world. But we are simply dealing with a definition here and a definition that's in the Equality Act. And I do hope that at some point we can hear the Cabinet Secretary confirming his view that there are two sexes. One of the things that has changed is there is now a conversation about there being more than two sexes and that it is a spectrum. And it's not going to be defined and determined in this bill. And therefore, you know, that's why at this stage I won't press it. But it is a part of the debate that's going on around this area. I also note that people have talked about the need for respect. Can I just ask, I understand that the parties have met to talk about freedom of expression and there will be further meetings. I think there is some anxiety that process is not transparent. I don't know if the convener is able to comment on how we can ensure that people who have expressed concerns to the committee about the impact on their ability to say what they think in terms of this bill, it would be important to know how is the Cabinet Secretary going to meet with groups like For Women Scotland and others who gave evidence to the committee. Will there be a chance for people to stress test that? I mean, I realise I'm slightly out of this, but I do think it's all in context. You have to understand that even in raising these issues, people like myself have been accused of stirring up hatred, which is precisely what this bill is dealing with. So you can understand the need for these anxieties to be addressed. But I thank the committee for considering what has been raised here, and I won't be pressing or moving amendments at this stage.
Thank you. It might be appropriate to say some words about where we are with freedom of expression clauses at the end of this process. But in the meantime, Joanne Lamont has indicated that she does not wish to press Amendment 90. Are members content that Amendment 90 be withdrawn? Members are content. So can I call Amendment 91, please, in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 90. Joanne Lamont to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. So the question is that Section 14 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 92 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
So the question is that Amendment 92 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 93 in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 31. Joanne Lamont to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. So I call Amendment 94 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 19. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 94 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 96 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 31. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 96 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 97 in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 31. Joanne Lamont to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. I call Amendment 98 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 31. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved.
That's moved. The question is that Amendment 98 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that Section 15 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 99 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 32. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. I call Amendment 99A in the name of Margaret Mitchell, already debated with Amendment 30. Liam Kerr to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. I call Amendment 99B in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 90. Joanne Lamont to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. I call Amendment 99C in the name of Joanne Lamont, already debated with Amendment 90. Joanne Lamont to move or not move?
Not moved.
That's not moved. So none of the amendments to that amendment were moved. So there's nothing for the Cabinet Secretary to press because that amendment's already been moved. So the question is that Amendment 99 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? Amendment 99 is agreed to. The question is that Sections 16, 17 and 18 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 100 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 33. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 100 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that Schedule 2 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that Section 19 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 101 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 46. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 101 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that Sections 20 and 21 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. I call Amendment 102 in the name of the Cabinet Secretary, already debated with Amendment 33. Cabinet Secretary to move formally.
Moved, Convener.
Thank you. The question is that Amendment 102 be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. The question is that the long title be agreed to. Are we all agreed? We are agreed. That ends stage two consideration of this bill. Could I place on the record, please, my thanks to the Cabinet Secretary, to Joanne Lamont, to Dean Lockhart and to Margaret Mitchell, and to all of the members of the committee for the way in which they have conducted themselves during this stage two consideration of the bill. We all know that this is a difficult bill and has generated a lot of controversy and not a little heat. And I would just like to thank all of my colleagues for the way in which they have conducted themselves during the consideration of stage two, and to place on record again my thanks and indeed my debt to the clerks and to all of the staff who support the committee in their work. Members will know that discussions are underway between the parties and the Cabinet Secretary about stage three amendments, in particular stage three amendments relating to freedom of expression. Joanne Lamont referenced those discussions a few moments ago. Those discussions will continue, and I think we are all determined to try and ensure that they are as transparent and open to the public and to all relevant stakeholders as possible. Formally, may I say this, colleagues, the bill will now be reprinted as amended at stage two and will be published online tomorrow morning. The Parliament has not yet determined when stage three will be held. Members will be informed of that in due course, along with the deadline for lodging stage three amendments. In the meantime, you'll be glad to know that stage three amendments can now be lodged with the clerks in the legislation team. That is the end of that item of our business this morning. Colleagues, item two on our agenda is consideration of two negative SSIs, namely the Parole Board Scotland Amendment Rules 2021 and the Fireworks Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021. Before we consider these instruments, can I point out to members the correspondence we've received relating to the second of these instruments on fireworks? We've received a letter from the Minister for Community Safety, Ash Denham, saying that there has been an unintended error in the drafting of the Fireworks Scotland Amendment Regulations and that she intends to revoke these and to bring forward a new instrument later this week. And can I thank Ash Denham for her letter explaining all of this to us. And secondly, we've been sent two letters from the British Fireworks Association raising objections to this instrument. The association also says that the industry has not been consulted with the details of the proposed legislation in accordance with the requirements of the Fireworks Act 2003, and that the industry does not agree with the content of the regulatory impact assessments. So may I suggest, colleagues, that in relation to SSI 2021-14, which is the Fireworks Scotland Amendment Regulations, we do the following. First, we state for the record that the committee makes no formal recommendation on the Fireworks Scotland Amendment Regulations 2021 on the basis that the government has made a commitment to revoke those regulations. And secondly, that we ask the Minister for Community Safety to respond to the concerns drawn to our attention in the correspondence from the British Fireworks Association, making it clear in her view if they were consulted and if they weren't, why they weren't. And it might also help if she can make it clear why the association believes that the regulatory impact assessment seems to indicate that they are in favour of the instrument, when from their correspondence it would seem that they are not. And finally, it might help if the Minister could at the same time also address the policy points raised in the British Fireworks Association's correspondence to us. Are members content to proceed on that basis? Members are content. I'm very grateful. Thank you very much. Do members have any comments on the Parole Board Scotland Amendment Rules, which is the other of the SSIs in front of us? No member has indicated that they have any comments to make on the Parole Board Scotland Amendment Rules. So that concludes consideration of the SSIs, and it also concludes our meeting today. Our next meeting will be on Tuesday, the 23rd of February, a week today, when we will start, and indeed we hope to complete, stage two consideration of the Domestic Abuse Protection Scotland Bill. I now close this meeting. Thank you.